Hi everyone, in this video I will show you how to calculate average of array elements using pointers. Okay, so we have seen we have done multiple examples in array, how to calculate the average, how to calculate the sum of the elements, right? And how to compare after calculating the sum or average, how to compare that with the individual elements. All those things were done in the previous, you know, when I was teaching you the array. So now let's see how we can actually, you know, calculate using pointers. You might wonder why can't we use array indexing itself to calculate the average. As I said, it is much easier to execute if you are using pointers instead of indexing to calculate the average and sum and average of array elements. Now you see here, I have got all the header files over here. No doubt I have got all the header files over here. Now main function is open. I have defined the array, int array, declared the array, int array equal to, all the elements are also given over here. Size is not required to mention because you are giving the elements, so it is redundant to give the size. You can give, you cannot give, doesn't really matter. Now I am defining some of the variables. First of all, I am defining the pointer variable s, okay, to pointing to what, that we give later. So that's a pointer variable. I also need, because if I need to calculate the loop, calculate the average, I need a loop. So for that I need an I, obviously I need an I equal to 0 I'm putting over here. Then I need another variable called sum to calculate the sum, right? To calculate the sum, I need another variable called sum, which is equal to 0. Let's see with these variables, can I actually calculate it or not? Now since I cannot put a semicolon over here, I need to put a comma. Now sum is equal to 0, fine. Here I will just put some pointer s equal to, because it should show the array element. So pointer s equal to array, that means it indicates the address of the first element in the array. So that is correct. Now I am using a while loop. While, how many elements are there? I less than 5. I less than 5. So I open the brace over here and I will put sum equal to sum plus star s, right? Because I need the value, not the address. So I'm putting sum equal to sum plus star s. Is that enough? No, that should increment. So I put s plus, so incremented. Then I also need what? Loop should also run. So I put I plus, so loop will also run. So that is over. Right, so I forgot to put a semicolon. I put a semicolon, close the brace. That is done. Now I will get the sum. Right, once I get the sum, I can write printf. I can write here it as. I can write here as printf percentage d. percentage d is sum, okay, percentage d is the sum, comma, what is that, sum itself, okay. Then I can put new line, sum semicolon. Then I can write here printf to get the average. I can write percentage d is the average and put sum divided by, what's the total number of elements? 5. We have got 5 elements, so I can put it as 5. I can also put it as, you know, I, if I know the number. So I'm just putting it at 5. Okay, so percentage D is the average, average, so sum by 5 is given. Okay, now I can put return 0 and semicolon, putting semicolon over there, then close the brace over there. I hope everything is correct. Now let me run this program. So 24 is the sum and 4 is the average. So I put the slash in wrongly, so I can put the slash in at the end of sum. Slash n. So 24 is sum and 4 is the average. I hope this is understood. 5 elements, right? So total sum is 24, 2 plus, so 8 plus 7, 15 plus 4, 19 plus 5, 24. 24 divided by 5 is how much? 24 by 5 is around 4 point something. So since it is an integer, you get 4, right? So that's fine. I hope this video is clear. So this is how, why we are using array. So you will, as I said before, you will not understand the advantage of using array, sorry, pointer in calling the array with using a very small program. But if you are using, if you are having modules and modules of programs, like long list of program, wherein you are using indexing, if you are using, it might take, you know, several hours to execute. So that time can be minimized. Okay, that can be minimized as much as possible if you are using pointers instead of using array indexing. Okay, so this video, I hope this video is clear. If you have any doubt, you can put your questions in the Telegram channel itself. You can ask me the questions there. You can write down your questions over there. Okay, stay tuned for the subsequent videos. Thank you.